family, and welcome to the 28 Days of Love. Yes, 28 days. We're going to be talking about love every single day. I'm going to drop lesson about love every single day. And February the 1st is day number one. So let me tell you why I wanted to do this. Because love is in need of love today. And this is the month of love. And because this is the month of love, I wanted to focus in on love. Did you know that the Greeks had over 30 different terms for love? Whereas in the English language, we only have one. But there's so many variations of love. There's so many types of love. And just think about it. The type of love I have for my son is not the type of love that I have for my man. And so it's important that we really understand love. And so every day I'm going to give you some information. I'm going to give you quotes. I'm going to interview some people about their experiences about love. We're just going to go in on love all month long. So I want you to hashtag 28 days of love. And then at the end of the month, the end of the 28 days, we're going to have an event, and the event is going to happen at La Petite Déjeuner here in Detroit on East Jefferson at 7 p.m. I'm going to have the phenomenal Zanier singing to an acoustic guitar. I'm also going to have the funny man himself, Antarell McCoy. It's going to give us a little comedy, and then everyone will go through your essential love style. Find out what your essential love style is. All of that's happening this month, in the month of February. But let me dive into what we're going to talk about today. Today, we're going to talk about self-love. Loving yourself. Do you really love yourself? How do you love other people if you're not loving yourself? How are you teaching other people how to love you if you don't love you? So I want to dive into the signs that you have a healthy self-esteem, that you have self-love for yourself. So the first thing is that we need to really understand what the word love means. And love is an intense feeling for a person, a place, or a thing. And yes, I said a person, place, or thing. So of course we can love people, but yes, we can love places. There are places that we go that we love, that we want to go to over and over again. One of my favorite places on the planet is Jamaica. Love it. And also things. We can love things. Sometimes we love our shoes, we love our clothes, we love our coats, we love our cars, men. But there are things that we love. And so we have that intense feeling for something or some place or someone. Those are some of the feelings that generate for love. And some of the words that we look at when we go through that thesaurus that means love is adoration. Who do you adore? What do you adore? And who adores you? Attachment. Who are you connected to? Who do you have attachments, healthy attachments with? Because it's so important to know that attachments can be healthy, and then sometimes we are too attached. We may have enmeshed relationships with people that we don't know how to move and let them have their space and we have our space. Have you ever been around that smothering person that doesn't let you do anything? They want to know what you're doing every moment. That smothering parent that won't let the child do anything even though the child is grown. So yes, we need to make sure as we're loving that we're loving in a healthy manner. So in order to have this intense feeling of love, do you have that intense feeling of love for yourself? Do you? Do you have a healthy self-esteem? So the first sign that you have healthy self-esteem is that you have the ability to assert your wants and your needs. And let me say this about the word assert. Assert does not mean you're aggressive. Asserting does not mean that I have to roll my head or roll my eyes. I can simply say, this is what I want. This is why I want it. This is what I need. This is why I need it. And when you really understand how you're wired, when you understand why you do the things that you do, then you can be very clear to the people that are in your space what you need, why you need, and you can be assertive in why you're doing it. The second thing is that you're confident at your ability to make decisions and choices. And so think about it. It's important to have wise counsel, but at the end of the day, you need to be confident in your decisions, about your feelings, about what your gut is telling you. Have you ever had a feeling in your gut that told you don't go that way? And then you went that way anyway, and it was a disaster. So you gotta trust yourself. And we have a mechanism that God has given us that will that guides us. And so we have to have confidence in that, in ourselves. And so we need to build that confidence within ourselves. Also, the next thing for you is that you know how to form secure, stable, honest, healthy relationships. Can I say that again? You know how to form secure, honest, healthy relationships. And so the people in your world, you have trust in them and they can trust in you. That you know how to form friendships. And I think that as we teach our young people, we should teach them how to form healthy relationships. But the number one way that we teach our young people is by modeling. So what are we modeling? Are we modeling to them what it looks like to love ourselves and not be arrogant, not be haughty, but just have a healthy sense of self? The next thing is that you also have you're realistic in your expectations about what you're gonna do and how you're gonna do them. That you don't have a grandiose view of yourself. You're not a narcissist. Everything is not about you. Loving yourself does not mean that everything is about you. You know when to talk and when to listen. You understand that listening is a skill and that hearing is a bodily function. But you know how to listen. You know how to give. You know how to receive, because some of us are givers. And because we're givers, when someone gives to us, we don't know how to receive. That is a circular thing. You can never always be in the same space. You have to be open and realistic in your expectations. Then you are also resilient when you have self-love, that you can take a licking and keep on ticking. As my wonderful, amazing artist, Donnie McKirkland says, we fall down, but we get up. And we understand that failure does not mean stop. Failure just means I don't do it that way the next time. You understand that maybe you have loved and lost, but it does not mean that you're not loving. It does not mean that you're not lovable. And it does not mean that you will not love again. You're resilient. And you don't allow other people to get you off of your square. And so I'm reminded of a time that my son, who just turned 26 yesterday, oh my God, but my son got in trouble. About 9, he got in trouble, got kicked out of school, and he really wasn't a bad kid. Didn't give me trouble as far as getting in fights and things of that nature, because I couldn't wait to get to him to find out what caused him to lose it. And oh, did he tell me, someone called his mother fat and black, and he clocked him. And I says, oh, wait a minute, hold up. He said, your mama was fat. Every scale that I step on, the weight that comes up says obese. Obese is another word for fat, so that is a fact. Then he said that your mother is black. I said, have you looked at me lately? Mm-hmm. I'm a dark girl. Mm-hmm. So that is a fact. But let me ask you some questions. The fact that I am fat and I am black, does it mean that I'm not a good mother? He said, no. Does it mean that I don't love you? He said, no. I said, does it mean that that little boy wouldn't be the better for being in my space? He said, no. I said, so never allow someone to get you off your square for a fact. And the only reason that I'm able to say that, because I'm okay with the skin that I'm in. Oh, trust and believe, there was a time that I didn't like all this chocolate, but today, I tell me you can't handle all this chocolate, I'll put you in a diabetic coma, or you'll have a mouthful of cavities because it's a whole lot of chocolate over here. So I just am resilient to the fact that I love me and I'm expecting other people to treat me well. Resilience. And then the last of the things that is important for you to understand if you have a strong sense of self is that you're able to forgive yourself. And you're able to forgive yourself for the things that you may have done wrong and your shortcomings, or when you missed the mark, or when you said something that you really didn't mean, or you did something that you knew was wrong. Your intent wasn't right. Forgiveness is a huge thing, and it starts with being able to forgive yourself. So when you love on you, you also will say positive things to yourself about yourself daily. So as you spend this next 24 hours, I want you to focus on loving yourself. I want you to focus on having self-care. And that self-care doesn't just mean getting a massage and doing those type of things, although those things are important. But self-care means knowing when to say no, knowing when to say yes, and taking the leap to do it. Saying something kind to yourself, about yourself, loving you, appreciating you, being affectionate with you. Be kind to you today. That is day number one. We got 27 more days to go. Hashtag 28 days of love. Stay tuned for more and more and more on love. I'm Dr. Sabrina, the people expert. I help people with people, even if that person is themselves, because I say it all the time. We think it's somebody else that needs help, but it's really us standing in the need of some help. That's what I do. I'm here to help you with loving. Take care.